we're much more willing to destroy insects without the conscious thought of their importance or repercussions to the greater ecosystems, because they're so small and kind of gross. Yeah, and kind of gross. And sometimes they are a little bit scary. There are some in New Zealand that are a little bit dangerous, but in other countries there's some that can kill you. So it's totally natural to be a bit scared of them, yeah. I'm the Science Centre Manager here at Otago Museum. What we're in right now is tropical forest, and tropical forest has been open for about 10 years. In tropical forest we have heaps of butterflies. We have over 1,000 flying at any one time. They're from the Philippines and Costa Rica. And there's some really beautiful show ponies that I can see flying around right now. On top of that we also have tarantulas, turtles, and some giant stick insects. Yeah. But one of the really big problems is that your average kid, right, even me growing up, you see a spider, you kill it, or you get it outside, or you scream and you jump on the couch. You see a fly, you get out the black flag. So it's really important that kids have a good relationship with insects, because they're going to be the ones that are kind of potentially going to be the leaders in conservation, right, in the next 20, 30 years. Insects are like really important biodiversity kind of marker. Like, they're a really good cornerstone of our ecosystems, and they're an indicator of what's going on. So if there's not many insects, or there's declining insects, it's a really good indicator that something much more sinister or something bad is going on for the whole entire ecosystem. So it's really important that kids kind of enjoy them and get to know them and be around them, so that they value them and so that they see them in their day-to-day lives and want to see them, you know, want to appreciate them and understand their role in the garden and how we grow things. Understand their role in pollination and the fact that, you know, pretty much everything in our cupboards would be gone if it wasn't for these really important insects, even butterflies that pollinate things. So bees are really, really important. Lots of different insects play these crucial roles in our day-to-day life. There are undoubtedly lots of people that are always a bit scared of the insects, and lots of people that don't even realise they're gonna be a bit scared. They'll wander in maybe, and actually an interaction with a butterfly will give them a bit of a fright. Just the unpredictability of them sometimes. There's definitely just innate evolutionary stuff inside of humans that we should be a little bit scared of things that are erratic around us. And you should be wary of things that are quite colourful, because they normally indicate that they kind of carry some sort of poison or something with them. My partner, who actually works here, has worked here for about 3.5 years, and she's only been able to come into this particular room once because she's so scared of butterflies, like actually petrified, yeah. Yeah. I would hope that visitors will kind of refresh and renew and have a different vantage point on what they're looking at when they see an insect next time at home. See that it is really crucial in our ecosystem. See that it's really actually incredible, the processes that go through, metamorphosis, all these different astounding biological evolutionary feats. And be able to give them a little bit more chance. Be able to put them in that glass with a bit of paper and get them out the window instead of just slapping them with a bit of paper. So yeah, really like understanding how crucial they are to our environment and our society.